So now we'll see the next curved surface area, volume, and volume of the next 3D figures, that is sphere. So as we see, like as we see, the sphere is like a ball. If you have seen the ball, ball is actually a 3D figure, and it's in the form of a circle. It's actually in the form of a circle, so that's why it is known as a sphere. So any 3D figure in the shape of a ball is known as a sphere. Like if you take the example of Earth, it is also in the spherical shape. So all these are the spheres. So most importantly, we need to find out the curved surface area and the volume of the spherical bodies. How to find out the curved surface area is, like as it is a sphere, that is it has a circular part, so definitely it is having some radius. So to find out the total surface area or curved surface area, in this case total surface area is same as that of the curved surface area. So to find out the curved surface area of a sphere, this formula, which is known as 4 pi r square, this formula is used generally to find out the total surface area or curved surface area of a spherical bodies, and to find out the volume of a sphere, which that will be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. So using these two formulas, we can easily find out the volume, curved surface area of the spherical bodies. Then r here denotes the radius of the sphere. So by keeping the value of r, we can easily find out the volume and the curved surface area. In the same way, the next 3D figure is hemisphere. Hemisphere is actually the half sphere. That is, if the sphere is cut in between, it actually forms the hemisphere. Like if the ball, if you can ball the cut from between, it actually shapes like a hemisphere. Or you can say the ball. So shape of ball is actually like a hemisphere. So in the case of hemisphere, again we need to find out the curved surface area, total surface area, and the volume of the hemisphere. So to find out the total surface area, or you can say the curved surface area. So to find out the curved surface area means this is the curved part of the hemisphere. So that is, we need to find out the surface area of this curved part. So and what how to find out the surface area of the curved part is, the surface area of this curved part is 2 pi r square. And if we need to find out the total surface area of this hemisphere, hemisphere, then this includes this curved part plus the circular flat surface that is there above the on the top of the hemisphere. So this circular flat surface, we need to add the area of this circular flat surface to the curved surface area of the hemisphere. So as this is a circular part, so definitely the area of this circular part is pi r. So it means curved surface area, that is 2 pi r square plus pi r squared. So this will become 3 pi r square. So this is the total surface area of the hemisphere. Now volume of the hemisphere, as it is the half of the sphere, so definitely volume will also get half. So volume of the hemisphere will be 2 by 3 pi r cube. So these are the formulas with the help of which we can easily find out the total surface area, curved surface area, and the volume of the 3D figures. So now we see some examples. On the basis of that, we can easily see how to solve the examples using these formulas. So first, note down the example. 3 cubes are joined end to end, which are of side 5 cm. So we need to find the surface area of the resulting cuboid. So in the question, it is given that there are 3 cubes which are joined end to end. So when 3 cubes are joined end to end, and each cube is of side 5 cm, so as 3 cubes are joined end to end, so definitely if we join these 3 cubes, it actually forms the cuboid. And as it forms the cuboid, so length of the cuboid will definitely increase, but the breadth and height of the cuboid cube will remain the same. So it means, like suppose there are these 3 cubes, Now there is a second cube which is just attached to this first cube, that is so in this way these three cubes are attached end to end. So as these three cubes are attached as end to end, so definitely their length will increase. So it is actually forming a cuboid whose length is increased, but breadth and height are same as that of the cube. So most importantly, we need to understand how will be the figure of this, and accordingly we need to analyze, like if we are attaching the cubes with their ends, what is increasing its length, breadth or height. Accordingly we need to take the dimensions of the cuboid. So in this way we get the figure when we attach three cubes. So as you can see that the, generally we take this as the length, take this as the breadth and this as the height. So as you see, the height is remain the same, because as three cubes are attached to end, so it is actually forming a one big cuboid whose height is same, that is this part is same, breadth is also same, but their length has increased as each side is of 5 cm initially of the cube. So its their length, its length, new length of the cuboid will be 15 cm. Breadth remains the same, that is 5 cm, and also height remains the same, that is 5 cm. So in this way, if we have noted down the dimensions, so now accordingly we need to find out the surface area of the resulting cuboid. So to find out the surface area of the resulting cuboid, if you see there again, this is the cuboid which is having the 6 surfaces. So this front surface having dimensions 15 × 5, so surface area of this front surface will be 15 × 5, that is 75. Again its back surface having the dimension 15 × 5, so it means again the surface area of that part will be 15 × 5 plus. Now again there is top surface, bottom surface. Now dimension of top surface are 15 and 5 again, because length is dimensions are length and height. Length is, if you see, length is 15 cm and height is 5 cm. So again the surface area of that part will be 15 × 5, and similarly the surface area of the bottom face will be 15 × 5 plus. Now there are two side faces, and the dimension of the side faces are 5 and 5, so it means surface area of those parts will be 5 × 5 plus 5 × 5. So this is the surface area of the whole resulting cuboid. So now if we solve this, so we'll see what will be the answer. So 15 × 5 will get 75. The same way 75, 4 times will be added, and then 5 × 5, 25, 2 times will be added. So if we add all this, we'll get 350 cm² is the answer. So this is the surface area of the whole resulting cuboid that is made when three cubes are joined end to end, and each cube is, has a side of 5 cm. So as these three cubes are joined, so definitely it is forms a cuboid whose length is increased, but breadth and height are same. So accordingly we have seen the dimensions of this resulting cuboid, and accordingly we have find out the surface area of this resulting cuboid. So now we move on to the next example. First write down the question, that is, from a solid circular cylinder with height 10 cm and radius of the base is 6 cm. So a right circular cone of same height and same radius or same base is removed. Find the volume of the remaining solid, then also find the total surface area. So in the question it is given that there is a right circular cylinder which whose height is given as 10 cm and radius of the base is given as 6 cm. And from that cylinder a right circular cone of again the same height and same base is removed. So accordingly we need to find out the volume of the remaining solid and also need to find out the total surface area. So first we'll see how will be the figure of this question information given that is given. Accordingly we first draw the figures, so accordingly it is easier for us to understand the question properly and to solve the question. It is given that this is a cylinder whose height is given as 10 cm and radius of this base is given as 6 cm. Now the cone is cut of the same base that is having the same radius and same height. Cone is cut. So this is the cone which is actually we have cut down from the cylinder having the same base and same height. So accordingly we need to find out the volume of the remaining part and the total surface area of the remaining part. So how to find out the, well, first we need to find out the volume. So how to find out the volume of the remaining part? See, initially there is a cylinder. If we cut down the cone from the cylinder, it means like we have cut down the volume of the cone from the volume of the cylinder. So as we have removed the volume of the cone from the volume of the cylinder, that is the remaining part. Accordingly we can solve the question, and accordingly we can find out the volume of the remaining part. So it means we have to deduct the volume of the cone from the volume of cylinder to find out the volume of the remaining part. So how to solve it is, first we see volume. First we write down this part, this thing, that is volume of the remaining part is equal to volume of cylinder minus volume of cone. So first we'll see what will be the volume of cylinder and volume of cone, and accordingly we'll deduct them to find out the volume of the remaining part. So volume of cylinder, as we have seen, as we know the formula for finding out the volume of cylinder, that is pi r square h minus volume of the cone. The volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So now if we solve it, what we'll get, as you can see that the in the case of volume of cylinder and cone, the radius of the cylinder and cone is same, and also the height of the cylinder and cone is same. So that's why we have taken both as r and h. So now if we solve it, we'll get 2 by 3 pi r square h. So now we'll keep the value of r and h here and we'll try to solve it. 2 by 3 pi, keep pi as it is, r square h. So r square, as we have seen that r is 6 centimeter, so it means 6 square into h, and h is given as 10 centimeter. So we have kept the value of h. Now we'll solve it is 2 by 3 into pi into 6 square, that is 36 into 10. We can cancel out this 36 from 3, we'll get 12 here. So it means 2 into pi into 12 into 10, so we'll get 240 pi centimeter cube. So this is the volume of the remaining part that we got, that is from the volume of the cylinder we have deducted the volume of the cone. So accordingly we got the volume of the remaining part, that is 240 pi. If we want, we can keep the value of pi also and we can solve it further also. And now the second part of the question says that we need to also find out the total surface area. So for finding out the total surface area, what we need to do is total surface area. What we need to do is if we observe this figure, that definitely there is a curved surface part of the cylinder, and there is a definitely the surface area of the bottom of the cylinder also. but top of the cylinder is blank because we have cut it on the cone from there. But definitely there is an inner part of the cylinder which is actually in the form of cone. So it means we need to find out the curved surface area of this cone, which is this part, and which is actually the inner part of the cylinder. And we have to add this curved surface area of the cone to the curved surface area of the cylinder plus surface area of the base. So accordingly we can find out the total surface area of the remaining part. So for finding out a total surface area, first we will see the curved surface area of the cylinder. And as we know that the curved surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h plus, we need to add the surface area of the bottom of the cylinder, that is pi r square, plus now the curved surface area of the cone, which is actually the inner part of the cylinder. We need to add that part also because we need to find out total surface area, which includes its surface area of the outer and the inner body. So that is curved surface area of the cone. So curved surface area of the cone, as we know, is pi r l. Now we will keep the value of all this thing, and accordingly we find out the total surface area. So 2 into pi, we keep pi as it is. R is, as we know, that is 6, and h is 10, plus pi. R is 6, so 6 square, plus pi into r is 6 into l. So now we need to find out the value of l. L we know is actually the curved surface area. For finding out the l is actually the slant height. So for finding out the slant height, what we need to do is, we have seen how to find out the slant height, that is L square is equal to S square plus R square. So now, as we know that the value of H and R, so accordingly you keep the value of H and R, we find out the value of L, that is L square is equal to, H is given as 10, so 10 square, plus R is given as 6, so 6 square. So L square is equal to 10 square plus 6 square, that is 100 plus 36, that is 136. So L is equal to under root 136. So this is the value of L we got. So accordingly we'll keep the value of L here, that is pi r l, that is under root 136. And now we try to solve it. Is we'll take the pi common, so accordingly we'll get 2 into 6, that is 120 into 10, 2 into 6 into 10, that is 120, plus 36, that is 6 square, plus 6 into 136, under root 136. So 6 into under root 136. Now we further solve it, take the pi common, 120 plus 36, we get 156, plus, now if we solve this under root part, that is under root 136, that is as it is given that L is equal to under root 136. If we solve it part, what we'll get is, we take the first the factors of 136, so 136, factors of 136 are 2 into 34. So these are the factors of 136. We can also take the factor of 34, that is 2 into 17. But we are not taking it because if we see the here, that there is only one pair one pair is forming, that is of 2. And if we take the factors of 34, that is 2 and 17, there are no pairs of 2 and 17 there. So that's why we have not taken the factor of 34. So it will become, as the pair of 2 is formed, so we will take 2 outside, so it will become 2 root 34. And we write down here, that is 6 into 2 root 34, that is 12 root 34. So this is the answer, that is centimeter square. So this is the total surface area of the remaining part, that is we have cut down the cone from the cylinder. So the remaining part we got, so this is, in this way we can find out the total surface area of the remaining part. And if you want to further solve it, like we want to keep the value of pi here, we can keep the value of pi, and accordingly we can further solve it. But it is not necessary that you always keep the value of pi and further solve it. So if you keep it this way also, it is also the right, and accordingly this is the answer of the total surface area and the volume of the remaining part. So here again we have used the formula for the volume of the cylinder, volume of the cone, curved surface area of the cylinder and curved surface area of the cone, to find out the total surface area as well as the volume of the remaining part.